The controversy surrounding pandemic contracts entered into by the Philippine government with Formuli Pharmaceuticals has shed light on the procurement process in the Philippines. How a new company with little capital and no track record could bag 12 billion pesos worth of contracts with the government. First flagged by the Commission on Audit, the Senate has conducted 13 hearings and counting and has recommended the filing of charges against Formuli officers and former government officials. But one advocacy group says there is more to the issue than Formuli.
The story is much bigger than Formuli. It's very important for the government to look at the systems in order to ensure that government does its due diligence in entering into contracts given our taxpayer money, because this is our money as the people.
24 researchers from the group Citizens Budget Tracker poured over 20 billion pesos worth of contracts entered into by various government agencies as of August 2020, which at that time consisted 60% of the total publicly available contracts on the government's online portal. It found highly priced contracts when compared to the average prices in the market and in other contracts. A face mask in one contract was sold for 1,400 pesos a piece, when it was sold in other contracts for an average of 26 pesos, while it could be bought in the market for only 21 pesos. In another contract, an RT-PCR test kit capable of 200 tests was sold for 344,000 a piece, compared to less than 300,000 average price in the market.
If the government had bought these transactions at the typical or median prices. So we found the amount that you mentioned, around 319 to 550 million pesos would have been saved.
But these possible savings only referred to 5.4 billion pesos worth of contracts. Two-thirds of the documents they examined did not have sufficient descriptions or specifications, preventing them from comparing the prices of other products with the market price. The group also found that three suppliers who have been suspended were still able to secure contracts. Meanwhile, three suppliers which had foreign addresses bagged contracts ranging from 300 million pesos to 1.8 billion pesos.
Well, we actually do understand the need to possibly import some of these goods. But it's also important to, you know, check whether domestic suppliers are capable of providing some of these transactions.
But the group was quick to point out their study could only raise red flags on systemic risk and not conclude corruption or fraud, as the documents they examined do not include delivery receipts or supplier eligibility documents. The group said the Government Procurement Policy Board has been receptive to their findings and some contracts are in the process of being cancelled. ABS-CBN News has reached out to lawmakers regarding this issue but has yet to receive any response. The Senate probe on Formuli contracts resumes on Thursday. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.